We have a responsibility to defend our country. Our country is under threat because they want to scare away our people, they want to scare investments, they want to scare tourists, they want to scare the people of this country generally. But I want to say that Kenyans will not be cowed. Kenyans will not surrender to terrorists. We will not surrender our sovereignty to terrorists. These people are cowards who are resorting to harming and killing innocent civilians in our country. We know the nature of the attack of terrorists. We know it because it is a universal method that has been used in other countries, but they have failed. As they have failed elsewhere, they are also going to fail here in our country. We want to urge our people to come together. This is the time for our people to come together and work together in solidarity in the defense of our country.
While speaking earlier on at the scene of the blast, Police Commissioner Matthew Itere had tried to dispel fears of terror attack, attributing the blast to an electric fault, a theory that was quickly dismissed as false by the Kenya Power personnel.
But what we have also been able to establish is that the injuries they have sustained, it doesn't indicate a grenade attack, because we expected it to have some pellets from their body, but what we are getting are glasses. So we can rule out at this point in time that it was not a grenade attack, most probably an electric fault.
The intensity of the explosion was evident from the crater it created on the floor of the completely destroyed Asananda's house next to Mount Kenya University campus along Nairobi's Moi Avenue Street. Various personnel who visited the scene called on Kenyans to remain vigilant, as the government was on the other hand urged to use every available resource to fight terrorists within its borders.
I want to assure Kenyans that they are safe. They are safe. The only thing we are having is that those who are trained, and we have been saying it, that the Al-Shabaab had been training some people, Kenyans, and maybe they are the people who are blowing these grenades.
That indeed we are doing all what we can to make sure the city of Nairobi is as safe as possible. And you reckon that just a little while ago I talked about CCTV. In fact, my ministry is making sure that we are fast-tracking the issue of installation of these cameras in the city.
And I don't think that the responsibility now falls on the government alone. Of course, there's a responsibility in terms of investigation and in terms of, pre-investigation, so that we know that we are able to probably perhaps anticipate this kind of act in future, so that we are able to go approach this issue from a deterring point of view and not from investigating after it has happened.
Samuel Tawish, GBS News.